Hello again. This is Miss Saint Germain. My kids are all on technology. Also, my husband is playing Xbox right here. So I'm making videos. This one I'm making right now is going to be on rhyming and syllables. So I want to start this video by saying, kids don't just learn how to read. It's not just magic. There are lots and lots of building blocks and pieces that have to happen before we can get to really being a reader. So a couple of the beginning pieces are being able to rhyme and count syllables. So these are all under the umbrella. You might have heard the terms phonological awareness or phonemic awareness. I have a link down here that kind of explains what those two things are. You'll hear the terms thrown around. Phonemic awareness, the big thing about phonemic awareness is it is about sounds. It is all about sounds. You can teach phonemic awareness in the dark. You don't need any syllables. You don't need any kind of symbols. It's just sounds. Phonological awareness is a much broader term. So the thing to know is that we have to have these things to be a reader. Like they need to be in English. I need to be able to rhyme, they need to be able to count syllables, and those things lead to particular parts of learning how to read in English. So I'm going to break down rhyming and syllables. These are skills that would be kind of a beginning of the year skill. If my kids aren't rhyming by December, I put a lot of effort and energy in January to make sure that they're rhyming by the end of January. Counting syllables is like one of the very first skills I teach, so this video might be best for like your pre-K baby. Down here, I've got on the comment section, I've got links to, even though rhyming and syllables you can totally do without any kind of symbol or any kind of anything. I went ahead, I have a Starfall game for rhyming. I've got three activities for rhyming, and three activities for syllables, and I have three YouTube videos for rhyming and three YouTube videos for syllables for you down here. So I hope this is helpful. Again, this one would be more for like an emergent reader. If your kid is still struggling with the print and is really just working on sounds and letters, this is the video for you. So, not all languages have rhyming. My babies who speak English as a second language sometimes take a little longer to master this skill because it's other languages aren't built on these word families like our language is built on. So rhyming is being able to identify a word, match a word that has the same middle and ending sound. Cat, mat. That's what it is. We can all rhyme. We know what that is. I don't stress too much about rhyming because there are so many wonderful rhymes and rhyming books. My go-tos are Dr. Seuss and Mother Goose. I do nursery rhymes and we do Dr. Seuss and I helping the kids identify that these words rhyme and hearing that they rhyme, it is those are my two go-tos. When they're rhyming, we want them to be able to identify that yes, they rhyme or no, they don't rhyme. So I'll say things like mug, hug. Do they rhyme? Do they not rhyme? And they can say, yeah, they rhyme. And then I'll say mop, hat. No, they don't rhyme. So we want them to be able to identify words that rhyme and words that don't rhyme. We want them to be able to identify an odd man out. So I might say like stick, brick, hop. Which one didn't rhyme? Or I might say stick, hop, brick. Which one didn't rhyme? They need to be able to identify the word that doesn't rhyme. And then we want them to be able to generate a rhyme. So I might say hat, mat. What's another word that rhymes? And in this, I want you to know that it's super okay if they have a word that doesn't make any sense. Like if they do hat, mat, lat. Yeah, it rhymes. If they're just adding in a different beginning sound and it's a totally nonsense word, that's super okay, as long as it rhymes. So there's links below to help you with those things. Syllables. Syllables are clapping parts, like identifying parts of words. So what I teach with, how I teach syllables is I teach syllables with my classroom names, and I teach syllables with the months of the year. Those are the two big tools that I use to teach syllables. So the hardest one always, and it always gets me, the hardest one is one syllable words. So, because once I teach them how to like hear the word and clap it out, they want to add a syllable always to one syllable word. So I might say, Cole, how many syllables are in the name Cole? And they'll be like, Cole. Nope, just Cole. Cole. Jack. Always Jack. Nope, it's not. It's just Jack. So always I have so many different syllables in my classroom name. So like this year, Cole, one syllable. Tega, two syllables. Rafaela, four syllables. That's a fun one. So I teach, you can't just clap. I teach them to pop a finger up every time they clap. It just makes it a little easier for them to count because sometimes they'll be like, butterfly, two. And it's like, no, baby, you clapped three times. So teaching syllables is it is about like hearing the parts of the word and being able to count the parts of the word. This translates to being able to chunk a word later when you're reading, being able to break down a word and understand parts of words. That's this, it starts with this oral skill of counting syllables. I really like the links that I sent you that I have attached to this video. I hope this helps. These are things I tell my parents at open house. These are things that we just practice in the car. We practice rhyming games in the car. We practice syllable counting in the car. Your kid may already do this. It's kind of a skill that some of them get very naturally. It's a skill that some of them do not get very naturally. Either way is totally fine. I'm not terribly worried. Your kindergartner or pre-K teacher is not going to be terribly worried. But if you do not have a degree in education and you are wondering what to do and where to start, this is where to start: rhyming and syllables. So I hope this video is very helpful to you. The easiest way to get these is going to be to subscribe to my channel. I'm going to get out another couple of videos shortly here that are going to be about more phonemic phonological awareness, and then I'm going to flip over to math and start doing some math and science and social studies videos. And in those videos, I'm going to be really focusing on kindergarten standards. So I hope you're having a wonderful Friday. I hope everybody's taking a breath. We are almost to the weekend, although I'm not really sure what all that's going to change for us who are just at home. So, anyways, have a wonderful Friday.